Pretty hard to miss anything with this gun.
Well, I'll say one thing, Chris. This rifle's a big improvement over that blunderbuss you've been using the past few years.
You know, my wife insisted on my buying it. She got so tired of my alibis for never bringing home a deer.
Well, don't get your full quota the first day, Mr. Hodges. The marshal's planning on a 4 weeks vacation. Yeah, we'll see you come home with a pair of antlers this time.
Well, time for that.
Don't forget to roll up the back window, Frank.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
No, I think that about takes care of everything.
Too bad you can't go with us this morning, Buck.
Oh, somebody's got to mind the store.
Listen, make sure you finish laying out that vacation schedule we started working on yesterday.
Oh, don't worry, Frank. Anderson and McCauley are due back from their vacations this afternoon. The minute that they report for duty, I'll be out of here like a shot to join you.
Okay, you know where we'll be now. We're going to set up camp a mile or two behind Moose Jaw Canyon.
Well, I'll be in the office till after 3, Frank. If you need anything, just holler.
Okay.
Good hunting.
Thanks.
We'd be the first ones here.
First day of the season.
Going right up, there won't be any deer left.
Well, thanks to game laws, the deer outnumber the hunters about 20 to 1.
Maybe I better cover up the groceries.
Here, I'll give you a hand.
Think they're safe here in the ground?
What do you mean?
Well, bears.
Oh, there's nothing unfair around this country to worry about.
Want some more coffee?
I think we better get started, Chris.
Okay.
Well, which way are you heading?
You're the visiting fireman. Take your choice.
I'll go north.
Okay, I'll head south. Good luck with your new cannon.
Thanks. See you later.
Okay, Chris.
Frank! Help! thought you'd never get here.
Yeah, lie still, Chris. What happened?
The hunter shot me. He shot me and took off.
Yeah, let me take a look at this. Well, I can't see very much. I have to cut your pants, Chris. Better put a tourniquet on it. Yeah, Chris.
Try not to hurt you.
Did you recognize him?
No.
I can't figure it. Shoot a man and leave him?
I can't either.
Let's see, we get a stick here someplace. Here. That ought to do it. Here, hold on to that stick. I don't think it'll be a good idea if we try to move you, Chris. I'll get a doctor back here as fast as I can.
There he is.
You out of here. I have to carry you, Chris. Think you can stand it?
I guess I'll have to.
Good. Let's go. Take it easy, boy. Now, wait a minute.
Can you hold me?
Okay.
Here. Take that rifle. Hold on. Blanket under your head. Wait a minute. Is that better?
Yeah, thanks.
You may backtrack and follow us here, so try not to make any noise. Here. If he does show up, let him have it. I'll go in back to the car and call for help. And I'll bring the first aid kit back. You all right now?
Yeah. Thanks, Frank.
Thank you.
doctor on his way?
I couldn't call the doctor, Chris. That wild man put the station wagon out of commission, radio and all.
But why?
I can't figure it out.
You know, the last time anybody doused sulfur powder on me was in a foxhole on Normandy Beach.
You'll get out of this mess, too.
Can you get the boat out?
I'm afraid I'm not good enough for that.
What are we going to do, Frank?
Well, I'll have to walk back to that ranger station.
That's 20 miles.
Maybe somebody will pick me up on the way. Chris, if you have too much pain, take a couple of these.
You think he'll come back again?
I don't think so. He tried to run me down when he beat it out of here. Here's your canteen of water. Now be sure you loosen this tourniquet every 20 minutes and tighten it again.
All right.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
Okay, Frank. Expect you back so soon.
I had no choice. Wrecked his car a couple of miles back. I'd got him and my gun hadn't jammed. It's the only one we have left now.
What are we going to do?
Well, I can't take another chance on leaving you alone. We'll have to wait till Buck gets here. He must be on his way by now. Did you take any of those painkillers?
I was just going to.
Here. Well, your canteen's empty. Well, you'll have to take a couple without.
Not without water.
You can try.
Gotta have water.
All right.
Thank you.
I'm cold. Build a fire.
I can't build a fire, Chris. If he's anywhere around us, the smoke will give us away.
I'm cold.
I promise you, as soon as Buck gets here, he'll have everything to need.
Car feet first. You slide through and open the other door.
You get Chris to the hospital, head back here right away.
Well, how about you? You going after him alone?
I have no choice.
Frank, you don't even know where to start to look.
I know he headed up that ridge.
You better take my rifle.
No, I use Chris's. You get started right away.
All right.
Who are you? What's your name? You better come up with some answers fast, Buster.
Stryker. Bob Stryker.
Did you know the man you shot?
Never saw him before.
Was it an accident?
Yeah, it was an accident.
Why'd you run away then?
I don't know.
You don't know? You came back and tried to kill both of us.
I had to.
Go on.
I wasn't even supposed to be carrying a gun. I was out on parole. One of you is a marshal, is it you?
Yes, I'm a marshal.
Well, you know what happens to my parole when they found out I was carrying a gun. I had enough of the pen. I never want to go back there.
All right, Stryker. Let's go.